Welcome to the Rocket Right Show, starring Hurricane Betsy Barnes and Dr. Kay Solar. Two busy blondes with their fingers on the pulse of all things Louisiana. Events, health, leisure, entertainment, and more. It's the Rocket Right Show. And now, here's Betsy and Kay.
And welcome to Rocket Right. I am Betsy Barnes. A little solo this week. Dr. K is in Nashville, where her son has been nominated for a few awards. CJ Solar is bringing the house down wherever he's playing. So we're going to be sharing more about that in some upcoming shows. She'll be back with us next week. But this week, we wanted to share something really special with you about the connection between women-owned businesses and the fight against human trafficking and ways that we can prevent human trafficking. I had the pleasure of meeting Tim Ballard, who is the founder of Operation Underground Rescue, who has a global organization that is stopping and prosecuting human traffickers. This guy is a real-life superhero. And a movie has been written about him in which Jim Caviezel, who you might remember, played Jesus in The Passion of the Christ. He actually was the star of this movie that's coming in September into theaters across the country. However, he came to Lafayette recently to help launch a business by the name of TripChat, owned by Nicole Quinlan, who has been on our show before, and former Miss USA Ali Landry Monteverdi, whose husband was the co-writer and co-producer of this movie. Now, this was an amazing way to launch a business, but this was the first travel and tourism mobile app that actually has a click feature to be able to connect with the National Human Trafficking Hotline. It was a great event. We wanted to share that event with you because so many people came together. About 175 people came to see the preview of this movie. And I've got to tell you, it was a little difficult to watch at times. It is such a sensitive subject. But it also brings back the focus to some of the bills in the Louisiana legislature, authored by Valerie Hodges and supported by others in our legislature, that we need to do more to be aware of the signs of human trafficking and to be able to help those that are being victimized or involved, maybe even not without their knowledge, in the human trafficking trade. So in this show, we're going to share with you a little bit about the business launch of TripChat, the TripChat app that you can download right now. We're going to be talking with Tim Ballard, whom the movie was about, and I encourage you to look up Timothy Ballard and Operation Underground Rescue, OUR.org, and some things that Louisiana businesses can do. The Secretary of State, Kyle Ardoin, is also behind helping educate businesses to be able to be aware of the signs of human trafficking among customers, employees, and others. So hang with us. We want to share this information with you. We feel it's important for the future of Louisiana. And then we're going to talk a little bit about Songs of Survivors and the launch of that new nonprofit to help people who need a little help healing through music and art. So we're really glad that you could share this time with us, and we'll be right back, and we'll introduce you to some of these amazing people.
There's a joy of life you'll find only in Louisiana. A spirit of celebration that takes your senses places they've never been before. Where expressions of joy are an art form and our way of life. Where an abundance of good food, good times, and great music means there's more than enough to go around. Come one, come y'all. Come feed your soul in Louisiana. I'm John Goodman, inviting you to visit LouisianaTravel.com and plan your getaway today.
The use of opioids and addiction to opioids is on the rise, especially in Louisiana, and I wanted to be a part of the solution. If you have a family member or loved one that you are concerned about with regard to opioid use, please call my clinic, Advantage Health Solutions. You can speak with my nurse or you can speak with myself, and we will talk to you about how to get that person into treatment, and we'll tailor what we do to your needs, and we'll do what we can to get your loved one in treatment and onto the path to health.
Red Stick Music, Baton Rouge's live music calendar since 2014, with a full calendar available on the website 24/7, clickable links to artists and venues. View the entire weekend lineup at a glance and plan your outings with your friends. View professional recordings of local live musicians, watch interviews with people in our music community, and find additional resources. Red Stick Music, Baton Rouge's live music calendar.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser of the great state of Louisiana. Hurricane Ida has brought great devastation to our community. In time of need, Louisianans always step up and help their neighbor. This time is no different. We'll help our neighbors and friends get back as we always do. If you need help or know of someone that needs help or would like to volunteer or make a donation, go to volunteerlouisiana.gov. We are Louisiana Strong. Thank you.
Since the early 1800s, the Selassie family has played a significant role in the retail industry in Louisiana. Stuart Selassie has achieved the Certified Diamond Graduate designation from the prestigious Gemological Institute of America. What that means to you, whether it's appraisals, design, build, repair, or diamond sales, you have an expert you can count on. At Selassie's, you make all the right choices. Selassie Jewelry and Fine Gifts, in the heart of the Denham Springs Antique District. Find them on Facebook.
Are you a business owner that could use just one more customer? Those empty tables, vacant appointments, idle employees, and expired merchandise are missed opportunities. What if there were a community that connects you to high-value and motivated customers, giving you a competitive edge in the marketplace and increasing your revenue? Introducing Partners One. You keep doing what you do best, taking care of your customers, and we'll do what we do best, sending you new customers to take care of. Call us today to find out how Partners One can work for your business.
And welcome to Rock and Write. I'm so glad that you can join us. I am very excited to share with you the continuation of the development of a mobile app called TripChat. And I'm here with the co-founders and co-visionary authors, Nicole Quinlan and Ali Landry.
Hi.
Two dynamic Louisiana gals who are really bringing this app to the forefront of travel and tourism. So I'm so glad that you could just share with me as this has developed. Nicole has been on the show a couple of three times.
Yep.
We've talked. This is your first time to be on the show.
It is. It is.
And we're so glad that you could
Thank you for having me.
There's nothing more exciting to me than to see a new business grow and develop, but to see two Louisiana gals, two girls from down here in Acadiana, do something so incredible and extraordinary. And so I was blessed to be here for the launch of your business, but not just the launch, the preview of the premiere of a movie about human trafficking.
Yes.
And so tell us a little bit about that connection and how that ties in with TripChat.
Well, everything for us really came full circle tonight. You know, Nicole created this incredible app and actually invited me on board. And because I have such a passion for my state and sharing the stories and the history and culture, partly because I want my children to know where they came from, you know? And when she told me that we both share that same passion for human trafficking and spreading that awareness, you don't meet many people who say that, because it's not polite conversation. It's not easy conversation. It's hard for people to dive into that. And she's like, I think we could maybe put a button on the app for people, empower people. It's our way of shining a light on this issue. And it'll link directly to a human trafficking hotline. And then because my husband has the movie coming out in September, I was like, this is the perfect thing. Well, let's screen the movie, launch the app. We have the, and it just, tonight was just really spectacular.
It was phenomenal. It
really So TripChat, for those people that don't know, tell a little bit about TripChat.
So like you mentioned, TripChat is a travel and tourism app. with 12 categories to select from. The user sets up a profile, they select the categories, and we utilize geofencing technology. Our proprietary technology is audio billboards. So as you're out and about, you enter a geofence and the audio billboards spring to life, telling you the stories about, you know, the history and the culture behind the business or the person who founded the business or the best place to eat, all the hidden gems along the way.
And Louisiana is filled with hidden gems.
Oh my goodness. Filled with hidden gems that a lot of locals don't even know existed.
Right.
You know, I was sharing the story earlier as I was driving in from, I flew in last night from Los Angeles, and I'm driving from the airport to my house. I immediately turned on TripChat and I was getting all of these little pings and these audio billboards from places I'd passed down this street a million times. And now I knew what this place was and the historical relevance of this. I mean, it was just so exciting for me.
And it's also educational, so your children can
enjoy
it. Oh my
gosh.
They don't have to set up the app, or if someone's visually impaired, someone's traveling alone and just kind of feels a little lonely and tired of listening to the radio, they can just listen to all the things that they're passing as they travel. And so this is really a great marriage of two things. It's the opportunity to share something about Louisiana that's extraordinary and special in all the different ways. And I believe you said there are potentially 12,000 points of interest in our
state. There is. There's 12,000 points of interest within our database. So that's why we're encouraging business owners to visit our website, log into our portal. They can click and drag all of their content, and then that way we can light them up and share their story with everyone.
So your husband heard the story of Tim Ballard, and we're going to be talking with Tim Ballard in just a few minutes. Mm-hmm. Absolute superhero, unbelievable human being, superhero, no doubt. So share with us, you know, your husband's name for people that don't know, and a little bit about how he got involved with Tim Ballard and how he was inspired to share the story.
So my husband, his name is Alejandro Monteverde. He is a writer, director. He has a production company. And he really does films that, I think he really listens to the calling, like things that really land on his heart. He will never do a project for money, ever. But we were watching a program, I don't know, 60 Minutes, 2020, and it was about human trafficking. And I don't think we really had the awareness, like most people, that this is going all around us.
It's somebody else's town.
Somebody else's town, family. In another country, never around you. And it's when you see it, you can't unsee it, right? And so he knew at that moment he had to do something about it. So he began to write a script. And about a week later, his business partner was at an event, and Tim Ballard was speaking there. And he's like, we need to tell his story. And so once Alejandro met Tim and heard his story, he's like, this is a story I need to tell, like a real-life hero. So Alejandro wrote the film, directed it, and now we're bringing it to theaters in September.
And so a lot of people remember Jim Caviezel.
That's right.
And he played Jesus Christ in The Passion for the Christ. He actually plays Tim Ballard. He's one of my favorite actors, actually. Mm-hmm. And we just previewed this movie. It's gut-wrenching. It is thought-provoking. It will bring you to tears. It's beautifully edited. The cinematography is beautiful on such a difficult subject. But you actually look in the face of these innocent children and you see the pain and the helplessness and the suffering. And then you get to see what occurs without too much.
He never crosses like, you know, people get worried, you know, like, oh, let's go watch a film about child trafficking. That's not an exciting, it's a hard sell sometimes.
Yes.
So we really, he was really aware of how he crafted it to really care for the audience through the process and never cross that line, like really to take care of them. And I think he accomplished that.
I think he really did accomplish
that. He did. He protected the children within the
yes,
film.
Yes, exactly. That's
true. It was amazing.
That was
amazing.
He did. And so when you meet in a few minutes, you'll meet Tim Ballard. I don't think there's enough adjectives to describe him and his team. And I had no idea really the volume of human trafficking in the world. I had no idea it was a $150 billion industry to actually sell children for sex, which in itself is sickening to think that people would actually make money doing that. It's sickening to us.
Yeah.
But we all are empowered to be able to make a difference. And so by bringing this to light with the travel and tourism app, with an incredible movie, tell us about the difference that you feel like this movie is going to make in not only our awareness, but in our ability to change the culture of ignoring human trafficking.
Well, you know, like they said, it all starts, they really, OUR, meaning Tim's team, really believes in storytelling. And Nicole and I also believe the same way, and that's really what TripChat is. We're sharing all of the stories, the history, the culture through great stories, right? We really want to entertain people. The great thing is when we wanted to put this together, we were like, it would be so amazing if Tim Ballard could be here. This is who the film is about.
Right.
Like, what a treat to our audience. And as soon as we shared with him what we were doing, that TripChat would have a button within the app. So if you saw suspicious behavior, you could just, we're going to empower you as an audience, you know, as a user. You can press that button. It's going to send you directly to the child trafficking hotline. And also when we shared with him really what Louisiana was trying to do in this space, you know, it's still started, everybody's still like, that conversation is just beginning, but everybody really genuinely wants to do something. And all of the, we had a lot of people in politics and
a lot of government, leaders that really showed up today and
that could really do something.
Yeah. And they're ready to make a difference.
Ready to make a difference. And when we shared that with him, he's like, I'm there.
Yep.
So he came off of a mission to be here with us tonight. And I think it was such a surprise to our audience.
When he
showed
up. I
think a lot of people realize it, even though it was on the invite, when we said, you know, without further ado, Tim Ballard, and he got out of the audience and walked down to speak. I think it was just...
It was it. Everybody was so moved.
It was amazing. It was just the synergy tonight with all of our projects and all coming together for something so much bigger than us, right?
Yeah. It is bigger than us.
Way bigger.
It was so powerful. You know, we all felt it.
We did.
Yeah.
It was a collective
feeling
of empowerment, mm-hmm. but also...
Doing what's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Doing what's right.
That's right. There was a sense of, we can do this, and
yes.
we can make a difference, and now we're all called and aware. And so we have to do something. So
yeah.
The first thing you can do is you can actually download the TripChat app. And that's what you need to do. And then you can start putting in what you like about different things. Do you want to go to a museum or historic places? Or what do you want to do? And so there's 12 different categories. But if you see something that does not look right in a business, in a retail location, this is your opportunity to stop and take a moment and make a difference. And so we're also going to be speaking with Secretary of State Kyle Ardoin, who has put together an initiative inspired by you and by this opportunity for Louisiana Businesses Against Trafficking. So we're going to talk to him in a little bit about that. But thank you so much, Ali Landry and Nicole Quinlan.
Thank you.
For blessing us and sharing with us this, because no one else was doing this like this. And so this is a way that we all, 4 million people in the state of Louisiana, can make a difference. So what are you waiting for? Download that TripChat app, and let's get going and help human trafficking prevention. So we're going to be right back with Rocket Right. I am Betsy Barnes, and we'll be right back.
Thank you. My biggest concern was my family and being able to see me come home every day and know everything is going to be okay. I felt comfortable that I was being treated by some of the best. There were some scary points along the way, but it's just kind of like been a little blip in the road.
Money, wellness, fun. Rocket Right Radio takes you all across Louisiana and the nation with guests who live life to the fullest.
I'm Hurricane Betsy Barnes.
I'm Dr. Kay Solar.
You're going to love it.
Join us every week when we cover
everything under the sun.
Live and learn with the Wright sisters.
Politics.
Health.
Music and entertainment.
Local Lagniappe.
Rocket Right Radio. You're going to love it.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser of the great state of Louisiana. Hurricane Ida has brought great devastation to our community. In time of need, Louisianans always step up and help their neighbor. This time is no different. We'll help our neighbors and friends get back as we always do. If you need help or know of someone that needs help or would like to volunteer or make a donation, go to volunteerlouisiana.gov. We are Louisiana Strong. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Katie, Operation Manager here at Old School Barbecue. We're excited about all of the changes here at Old School, and we'd like to invite everyone to come out and enjoy some delicious barbecue at Old School prices. We feature brisket, chicken, ribs, sausage, and the Boss Hog pulled pork sandwich voted best deal in town. We also have live music Friday and Saturday from 7 to 10 p.m. 10655 Corsi Boulevard. We can't wait to see you.
Red Stick Music, Baton Rouge's live music calendar since 2014. With a full calendar available on the website 24/7, clickable links to artists and venues. View the entire weekend lineup at a glance and plan your outings with your friends. View professional recordings of local live musicians. Watch interviews with people in our music community and find additional resources. Red Stick Music, Baton Rouge's live music calendar.
You're invited to the second annual Flower Fest benefiting St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, April 2nd and 3rd at Point Marie. Get your tickets now for this two-day floral festival competition. Experience our out-of-this-world theme gala Saturday, April 2nd. Get your tickets at theflowerfest.com.
At TripChat, we believe special places shouldn't go undiscovered and good stories shouldn't go unheard. Imagine exploring a new area while listening to amazing stories about the places and people who made it what it is today.
This great waterway courses through 10 states, starting in northern Minnesota and ending in Louisiana. The connectivity of the river drains 41% of the continental United States and carries more water than any other waterway. The fabric of America truly is woven from the common thread of the Mississippi River.
This community tapas bar and grill reels in, sautés, and perfectly plates earthy yet refined flavors by marrying chic urban elegance with rustic Spanish simplicity. We transport flavors from traditional Spain fused with international tastes.
Over 240 different species of birds have been spotted making their homes around and in this lake. This beautiful lake is a great place for all kinds of recreation, like fishing, boating, picnicking, and a beautiful walking trail.
When you discover new places and learn what the locals already know, you maximize your experience.
Fill your tote with local treasures ranging from...
Immerse yourself in the culture and communities that surround you. With up to 12 categories to select from, stories are delivered to you based on your interest. TripChat, the free audible tour guide app that helps you discover great places through authentic storytelling, so you eat, stay, and play like a local. Download TripChat. Then drive, walk, or run, and go find your fun.
Whitetail Properties is not your average real estate company. Land specialist and MSU alum Jeff Taylor in Mississippi and LSU fan realtor Kate Taylor have teamed up. Their sole purpose is uniting buyers and sellers of recreational land. If you're interested in hunting, ranch, investment, and timber properties, Whitetail Properties experts have the right real estate for you. Call Jeff Taylor, 601-248-9433, or Kate Taylor, 225-719-0495, or visit whitetailproperties.com.
There's a joy of life you'll find only in Louisiana, a spirit of celebration that takes your senses places they've never been before, where expressions of joy are an art form and our way of life, where an abundance of good food, good times, and great music means there's more than enough to go around. Come one, come y'all. Come feed your soul in Louisiana. I'm John Goodman, inviting you to visit LouisianaTravel.com and plan your getaway today.
About Tim Ballard. So thank you so much for sitting down with me at the premiere, the preview premiere of the movie The Sound of Freedom, which is about your rescue of so many children that have been taken into human trafficking and slavery.
Thank you. It's amazing, that amazing audience. I love this state, truly.
Yes.
I love these, there's a special, I don't know, something special about these people here.
So I guess we had about 150, 175 people that as they were watching this movie, it was very riveting, and it's about Operation Underground Rescue. And so Tim Ballard, previously with Homeland Security, with the United States government, trying to rescue children, found that, is it a stretch to say the bureaucracy of trying to do what you saw needed to be done was too cumbersome? And so you decided that you felt called, no matter what, you had to do something different. So tell us a little bit about that, and why this is important.
More than, you know, the bureaucracy, it's also the jurisdictional limitations, right? I mean, unfortunately, we've set everything up in this world of boundaries and borders, but human trafficking doesn't know boundaries or borders. And so that's the kind of the problem I ran into is, you know, the laws changed in 2006 in this country when I was still an agent, and it allowed for the first time for U.S. agents to go overseas to find Americans who are sexually assaulting children and then hold them accountable as if they'd committed the crime here. So it's a great, great, you know, new law. The problem was, you know, they could only give me a week or, you know, 2 weeks at most, and I'd always find the kids, as you saw in the film. But I couldn't find the American nexus all the time. And so I had to, by mandate, come back. But I'd made myself the bait. So that was the dilemma. So finally, in 2013, I was working on a couple of cases, one in Colombia, which is in the film, one in Haiti. There's a documentary about that one. It's called Operation Toussaint, which is on Amazon. And I had already seen kids, and I had, in one case, talked to a parent of one of the missing kids. And it was like, I couldn't come back, you know. And I actually wanted to. I was a little bit cowardice, and I had six kids and thought, how am I going to feed them if I quit? It was my wife.
Right.
We had some very spiritual experiences, both of us. And my wife said to me in December of 2013, right when I was about to leave and then told her I was too scared to leave the government, and she said, and she's usually very sweet, okay, but she said, and this is verbatim because I'll never forget because it like penetrated my soul. She said, I will not let you jeopardize my salvation by not doing this. And she meant it, and I knew she meant it.
Words.
That was it, and I was in.
You can't argue with that.
I can't argue with it. No. I'm not going to get between her and her maker, so.
That's right.
I had to do it.
That's right. So through your wife's faith, through your own faith, you got in alignment with what the Lord wanted you to do, the Lord that you worship, and you felt called because God's children are not for sale. And that was one of the lines that you used in the movie. And also, it was really profound to see all the different people that you have somehow recruited and gotten involved in different countries at different levels to save these children who, for the most part, are nameless, who have lost their identity, they've lost their family, they've lost everything. And then you take it upon yourself to risk your life to save them. I mean, that's profound.
It's an amazing journey because, like you mentioned, the people that I found along the way who no one knows who they are. You know, part of my job is to actually be the face, but I don't always deserve to be. When I see my operators, these men and women who are risking their lives every day and no one knows and they don't want anyone to know. And I just look at them and it's like, you could lose your life and no one would even know why, you know.
Right.
But it's a lot of darkness what we're fighting, but there's so much light in being able to partner with people of light, who my operators are. Everyone in that theater tonight.
Yeah.
I just felt this. I honestly felt the spirit of God in that room.
Yes, absolutely.
It's because of those people. And so that's what gives me hope, is there is a lot of light still left. As notwithstanding the darkness, and it's growing, the light's growing too. And it's just finding those like-minded people who are coming to the cause and allowing us to do what we do.
So The Sound of Freedom is the name of the movie. It is the story of Tim Ballard and just one of his many adventures, one of his many missions to save children. So share a little bit about what you shared tonight about the volume and the number of children and the number that Operation Underground Railroad has rescued. But this is a sickening business. And so there's a really great chance that someone watching or listening is involved as a predator.
Oh,
or
for sure.
Is involved in some way with the human sex trade.
Yes.
Which is hard to believe that we're speaking to those as well as those who have lost children and family members to that.
Yeah.
So the value of that, a human life, there is no value on that.
Correct.
It's, you know, but tell us a little bit about this as a business and a trade.
Yeah.
And maybe if you're involved in that, you'll be ashamed. Yeah. And hopefully you'll turn away from what you're doing and get help.
People, yes, please do. People are shocked because the media doesn't match the numbers, right? The media attention doesn't match the numbers. So thank you for being brave enough to talk about something on your show that might be uncomfortable for people. But if we don't do it, we'll never solve this, right? So how big is it? It's $150 billion a year. That's how much money is spent in the buying and selling of women and children. That's the same amount of money that would be required, as I shared tonight.
Yes, please share that again.
Yeah, to purchase. With that amount of money every year, you could buy every Starbucks franchise, every NBA team, and still have money left over to send every American child to college.
Every American child to college for 4 years.
For 4 years.
Own every Starbucks franchise and every team in the NBA, and probably have a little pocket change left over.
Yep. And that's how big this is. And it's not going to end. I mean, we're happy. I mean, we would do everything we've done if we just rescued one. We would.
Yes.
I truly feel that. We've been fortunate enough to rescue, I believe, 4,700 is the number. About 3,500 arrests, and that's amazing to me.
Yes.
But statistically,
you rescued 4,800 children
and women,
47 women and children, and you've arrested 3,500.
Supported the arrest, 3,500 pedophiles and which I love that number, by the way, because I've seen studies that say that any trafficker pedophile could easily hurt up to 50 to 100 kids in a lifetime.
Absolutely.
So there's a lot of kids and women we're rescuing that never needed to know they needed rescuing because they were never taken, right? Because their guys, we put them away before. So I love that 3,500 number as well. But this is huge. This is another line from the movie, which is true. You know, this is now rivaling the drug trade because you can sell a bag of cocaine once, but a child or a woman you're controlling, you can sell 5, 10, 15 times within 24 hours.
Yes.
So it is very lucrative.
Which is a sickening thought.
It's sickening, but it's real.
Yes.
That's what happens. And it's very lucrative.
Yes.
So,
well, for people that money is more important than their soul, you know, and people can criticize and say, oh, I don't like the religious aspect of what you're saying or whatever. You know, everyone struggles with one thing or another. And everyone feels called to do one thing or another. Let this be your thing for 2022.
Yeah.
Let this be your thing that you want to educate yourself. You want to educate your children. You want to educate students, employees, business owners, anyone that you can impact by helping them be aware. This is happening right under our nose. It's happening in Louisiana. There are children and people that are missing. And they're not just always missing. Sometimes they're still living in their home, but they're being trafficked by a family member,
correct,
a friend, a neighbor. They're not your friend, but they call themselves.
That's right. Yeah, there's a lot of that going on. And unfortunately, these poor victims, they're already victimized. And the fact that the media is not giving this the attention, in fact, in some cases, they're coming out against the fight. They're lying about numbers to minimize the problem. I'm just going, why do you want the blood of children on your hands? What are you doing? But that's the world we live in right now is you know, calling good evil and evil good. And we need the good people, the honest ones, to rise up. And we got to combat this. There's
that's
nothing
right.
more important.
That's right. So, and this is a higher number of people currently in human trafficking, enslaved, than all of the people that the population counts. Of people when slavery was legal.
Isn't that crazy?
And now slavery is illegal. And this is definitely illegal.
It's illegal, thank goodness. But it's
not prosecuted enough.
It's not.
It's not made aware.
No, there's never been a time in history, and again, the movie points this out as well, where there's been this many people enslaved. Yeah, some estimates are between almost up to 40 million slaves. And this is slave labor, sex trafficking, and organ harvesting.
So organ harvesting.
We are working very diligently in several parts of the world on that, where children and adults, but children, pediatric hearts are about $250,000 from our estimate on the black market. And so in a lot of countries that take these kids and literally cut their hearts out and sell it on the black market, I mean, that's $250,000. I mean, it's sick, but it's happening.
So do you think that part of the problem is that when someone is victimized as a child or a young adult even, or a teenager, do you feel that there's victim shaming where the victims are so afraid to come out, it's so embarrassing and humiliating, they're so judged that they don't get the help they need?
Absolutely.
And a shortage of after care treatment.
Absolutely.
For people to kind of regain their sense of self and regain their dignity.
Absolutely. It's a symptom of us not talking about this. Every time I give a speech, and I think we were talking earlier off, you know, before the show, every time I go to a large conference or speak, I have multiple people who come up to me and in tears. Like, I've been abused. And you were telling me the same thing happens to you, right?
That's right.
If everybody knew how big it was, they'd feel more, you know, okay about coming out with it and get the help they need, because they're suffering. These adults are suffering when they were sexually abused as children.
That's right.
And especially men.
That's right.
They just have a hard time coming out and saying, and they need help. But everywhere we go, every time I speak, multiple people come up and say, I was victimized. And we can direct them. So that's another net positive, not only the prevention work, but the aftercare that will come when we start talking and normalizing this, making it part of our national conversation, which we haven't hit that yet. We need to.
We haven't hit that yet. No, we haven't. I want to continue my conversations with you, and I want to definitely let people know that your movie is going to come out in September to a national audience, and I'm hoping we can show it in Louisiana a couple more times, because I think we need
I would love to
see it.
Yeah.
But in September, it'll probably be premiering mid to late September, and you've got some big heavy hitters behind it promoting it.
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have the producers are a lot of known people. Tony Robbins is the producer of the film.
Tony Robinson.
Mel Gibson is
involved with this film.
There's a vast array. The Slim family, Mexico. They are the Walton family, members of the Walton family. It's some really important, influential people who are going to get behind this, and we hope it's going to be huge. I think it will. I think it'll be our biggest media kind of hit yet to bring attention, awareness, build our team, and give us the light we need to take into dark places. So
The Sound of Freedom is a story about Tim Ballard and his rescue and continuing rescuing of children from all around the world that are being sold into sex slavery and human trafficking. And thank you for answering God's call on your life.
Thank you.
And for listening to your wife, which is always a really good idea.
Good idea, yeah.
And so best of luck to you and your children. And we look forward to continuing this and helping shine a light on a really dark subject. It's really important, especially for our next generation or two or three. So thank you, Tim Ballard,
thank you,
for everything
Betsy.
You've done. And if you're going to rock it, make sure you rock it right.
At Hightower Dental Concepts, we take a compassionate approach to family dentistry. Our goal is to make your dental experience comfortable and informative so you can make the best dental care decisions for you and your family. We're welcoming new patients to our dental family at Essen and Perkins, and we look forward to meeting you soon at Hightower Dental Concepts. Call us today at 769-0031 or request your appointment at info@dentalconceptsbr.com.
Hi, I'm Katie, Operation Manager here at Old School Barbecue. We're excited about all of the changes here at Old School, and we'd like to invite everyone to come out and enjoy some delicious barbecue at Old School prices. We feature brisket, chicken, ribs, sausage, and the Boss Hog Pulled Pork Sandwich, voted best deal in town. We also have live music Friday and Saturday from 7 to 10 p.m. 10655 Corsi Boulevard. We can't wait to see you.
You're invited to the second annual Flower Fest benefiting St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, April 2nd and 3rd at Point Marie. Get your tickets now for this two-day floral festival competition. Experience our Out of This World theme gala Saturday, April 2nd. Get your tickets at theflowerfest.com.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And I present to you Sound of Freedom.
Use of opioids and addiction to opioids is on the rise, especially in Louisiana, and I wanted to be a part of the solution. If you have a family member or loved one that you are concerned about with regard to opioid use, please call my clinic, Advantage Health Solutions. You can speak with my nurse or you can speak with myself, and we will talk to you about how to get that person into treatment, and we'll tailor what we do to your needs, and we'll do what we can to get your loved one in treatment and onto the path to health.
Whitetail Properties is not your average real estate company. Land specialist and MSU alum Jeff Taylor in Mississippi and LSU fan realtor Kate Taylor have teamed up. Their sole purpose is uniting buyers and sellers of recreational land. If you're interested in hunting, ranch, investment, and timber properties, Whitetail Properties experts have the right real estate for you. Call Jeff Taylor, 601-248-9433 or Kate Taylor, 225-719-0495 or visit whitetailproperties.com.
I had a meeting with Dr. Barfield and it kind of just hit me. It probably is cancer. After the surgery, I wasn't scared anymore. I was looking forward to getting started with chemo. Not one time did I get a nurse in a bad mood. I was here for 5 hours at a time and I did not dread coming. To get people from around the country to come to Baton Rouge, that says a lot right there, that this is a place that's cutting edge.
Ardoin. So thank you so much.
Oh, good to be with you. Absolutely. Yeah,
thank you for taking a few minutes to talk about something that we're both very passionate about, and that is the prevention of human trafficking. And so recently it has become a little more, I guess, the topic du jour for human trafficking prevention. We're starting to see a little bit more of the messaging, but for several years we heard a lot about it. Then there seemed to be a gap through COVID and through some of the pandemic and some of the hurricanes and things like that. It wasn't as much a topic. There's been some bills through the legislature, and our state has tried very hard to stop human trafficking. But now we're back in the full swing of fairs, festivals, heading into any type of thing where people gather. And of course, that's where pedophiles and human traffickers go, because they're looking. They're looking for prey. So one of the things that you've decided to do to prevent human trafficking is start a new initiative among businesses. So tell us a little bit about that.
Yes, we're very excited about it. It's called Louisiana, LBAT, Louisiana Businesses Against Trafficking.
Yeah.
And it's not, you know, any particular group, but we want businesses to be aware and we want them to make their customers aware. And we'll be contacting them by letter and encouraging them to sign up to learn what the signs are of human trafficking so that they can assist law enforcement in stopping this insidious evil that's hitting our state and our country, the world.
So what do people need to do if they are a business owner? How do they sign up and become part of this movement?
Well, they'll be able to go to our website and join LBAT. And we're going to be sending letters out to inform them of this opportunity. Then they'll be able to get a sticker for their business door with the national 1-800 number, toll-free number, for people to call and report human trafficking so we can stop this.
So I have a business. It's called Rocket Right, LLC. It's registered with the Louisiana Secretary of State's
That's
office.
Right.
And so I am definitely going to be joining that. And I'm going to encourage other small businesses. But some people have such a small business, and they might own a small restaurant or something else, and they themselves might find that their workforce is a little short right now.
Yes.
They're having trouble finding employees, and they might be tempted to maybe hire people in a vulnerable situation. And I'm talking about some of the smaller restaurants in the bigger cities, because maybe they need some extra help, but it could be that those employees are being trafficked as well.
It could very well be. And for them to learn the signs of what a victim would show would be helpful to that victim, and helpful to our community. Because in essence, what we're doing is we're working to save our children. And anybody's children are our children, because they're
right.
our future. And to have their future robbed from them by sick, evil individuals, then we've got to stop that.
That's exactly right.
I think for me, and you said it earlier this today, God is calling us to act.
Yes.
And Christians have to stand up, and we have to act, and we have to be part of the action. And this is one way that the state of Louisiana and I, as Secretary of State, can do that. And it's a small piece, but the more we educate, the more we raise up the issue mm-hmm. and talk about it, yes. the less people are going to be afraid of it, and they can embrace it and try to protect our young people. Because just think, listening to and watching the movie Sound of Freedom, I connected with that little boy who had been stolen from his father.
Yes.
And in his face, I saw my 8-month-old grandson, and he was 8 years old. I can't imagine the pain that my daughter would feel or my wife and I would feel if something happened to him, like this insidious evil that's out there. And no one's really safe.
Right.
From what I saw in that movie, children were being stolen off the streets.
Yes.
You know, and in social situations, you get, if a parent gets distracted for one moment, they turn around, that child is gone.
Gone.
And I'll never forget, my mother went to one of those large warehouse stores, you know?
Yes.
And this was when Amber Alert was just kicking off.
Yes.
They shut that store down because a mother reported her child had been kidnapped. And they found the child in the bathroom. And that child, it was a young girl. Their hair had already been halfway shaved off their head and dressed
goodness.
In boys' clothes. So they were already going to change that child to look nothing like what the mother would be expecting. Thank God they had the resources to shut that store down and search for that child.
Whether that they actually did it that quickly.
That quickly. Because they had the panic buttons.
Yes.
I don't even know if that exists anymore. But bottom line is, that's really the call to action that we have.
Yeah. You know, every single legally operating business in the state of Louisiana has to register with the corporation's division of your office.
That's right.
So this is a great way to get the word out to businesses that we want them to be involved in the process of prevention through education.
That's right.
You know, so do you feel that maybe within a year we might see something in regard to a decrease in human trafficking in Louisiana?
I certainly would hope so.
Yes.
I know that Louisiana has a strong history, as you said, before the pandemic of stepping out there. I know that Father Bahi in Baton Rouge has some...
And the Metanoia
Foundation. Yes, Metanoia Foundation.
Yes.
And it's working really hard in this. And I think we just need to complement all those efforts. And if we as a state can step out there and say, this is important, then certainly business owners, and I think everybody could identify with, well, I want to protect my grandchild or my child.
That's right.
And all it is awareness.
That's right.
That's what we need, is awareness, so that people can call the national 1-800 number, report it to law enforcement, and they can get there as soon as possible and hopefully save somebody's life.
You're invited to the second annual Flower Fest benefiting St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, April 2nd and 3rd at Point Marie. Get your tickets now for this 2-day floral festival competition. Experience our Out of This World theme gala Saturday, April 2nd. Get your tickets at theflowerfest.com.
Since the early 1800s, the Selassie family has played a significant role in the retail industry in Louisiana. Stuart Selassie has achieved the Certified Diamond Graduate designation from the prestigious Gemological Institute of America. What that means to you, whether it's appraisals, design, build, repair, or diamond sales, you have an expert you can count on. At Selassie's, you make all the right choices. Selassie Jewelry and Fine Gifts, in the heart of the Denham Springs Antique District. Find them on Facebook.
The use of opioids and addiction to opioids is on the rise, especially in Louisiana, and I wanted to be a part of the solution. If you have a family member or loved one that you are concerned about with regard to opioid use, please call my clinic, Advantage Health Solutions, You can speak with my nurse or you can speak with myself. And we will talk to you about how to get that person into treatment. And we'll tailor what we do to your needs. And we'll do what we can to get your loved one in treatment and onto the path to health.
I had a meeting with Dr. Barfield and it kind of just hit me. It probably is cancer. After the surgery, I wasn't scared anymore. I was looking forward to getting started with chemo. Not one time did I get a nurse in a bad mood. I was here for 5 hours at a time, and I did not dread coming. To get people from around the country to come to Baton Rouge, that says a lot right there, that this is a place that's cutting edge.
Back. I'm Betsy Barnes, and Dr. Kay Solar is going to be joining us next week. She has been traveling all around, including in Nashville, and some great things are happening there. But we just want to tell you that there are wonderful things and wonderful people working together to help all of us all across the state. And so previously we've shared with you a little bit about Songs for Survivors. It's a 501(c) founded by David St. Romain that provides a healing arts music workshop for veterans. This has been supported by Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser since its inception. The Division of the Arts for the State of Cultural Development has been supporting it, and also the Office of Tourism. So if you know a veteran or you are a veteran, mark your calendars for April 9th. We want to invite you to a free workshop at the World War II Museum. And so you can sign up for that by going to SOS4music.org, or you're welcome to call Songs of Survivors office in David St. Romain. So we wanted to share a little bit about the open house of the office that has been 3 years in the making. There's also Baton Rouge Beats Lab for teaching at-risk youth and musically gifted or interested students how to make beats and loops to get into the digital music realm. So if you'll just take a moment, share this, share the apps that we're going to share with you. We're also going to talk about how we can employ veterans through a new mobile app called Melon Seed, M-E-L-O-N-S-E-E-D, and more. So just remember, if you're going to rock it, make sure you rock it right.
There's no words to explain all the guilt and all the shame.
Thank you all for being here today. This is a special day for me and for our team that have worked so hard on Songs for Survivor.
We started with working with underserved populations in Louisiana for arts, and veterans is one of our largest underserved populations. So as we were going through thinking of things we could do with them, we came up with the idea of doing a veteran songwriting workshop. We did four of those. We did one in Baton Rouge. We did one in Lake Charles, Alexandria, and Shreveport. We had three songs come out of those workshops.
We are survivors. We are fighters. We're here for the broken, for the pains unspoken.
We found, as we were going through this, Americans for the Arts contacted us about doing a military arts and military summit. Several states have had conversations and dialogues about this, but we're the first state to actually have a summit to sit down and bring all of the arts practitioners, humanities elected officials, as well as arts organizations and humanities organizations together in one place.
It takes leadership to lead, and I think in this particular point in time, Lieutenant Governor is providing that leadership and enabling the community throughout the state to provide that service to the military men and women that's so vitally needed.
So this is personal to me. It goes way back to my father being a Marine and to the way I was brought up in honoring our veterans.
This helps males, females, no matter what age group, we've had all ages, to find a common bond, to be able to share experiences in a safe place, to where they feel good, they feel supported, and it gives them an avenue, the arts give them an avenue to move forward.
I know the healing has begun. Every time these words are sung, but those memories of that time stands with a stillness in my mind. So I
guess you had to be there. I guess you had to be there.
Are you a business owner that could use just one more customer? Those empty tables, vacant appointments, idle employees, and expired merchandise are missed opportunities. What if there were a community that connects you to high-value and motivated customers, giving you a competitive edge in the marketplace and increasing your revenue? Introducing Partners One. You keep doing what you do best, taking care of your customers, and we'll do what we do best, sending you new customers to take care of. Call us today to find out how Partners One can work for your business.
Rock It Right with Betsy Barnes and Dr. K Solar is brought to you by these generous sponsors. Partners One, Better Barter for Baton Rouge and beyond.
Mary Bird Perkins, Our Lady of the Lake Cancer Center, Selassie Jewelry and Fine Gifts, Advantage Health Solutions with Dr. Boyd Michael Helm, Hightower Dental Concepts with Dr. Leah Larson, Citigroup Hospitality including City Pork Brasserie and Bar, City Pork Catering, City Slice, City Taco, Rouge Creole, and Beau Soleil.
Talent 360 Consulting with Vicki Little. Jeff Taylor, Realtor and Forester with Whitetail Properties. The Third Street Songwriters Festival. Elite Chiropractic with Dr. Ron McMorris. LouisianaIsATrip.com, take one. Thank you for making our show possible.
You're invited to the second annual Flower Fest benefiting St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, April 2nd and 3rd at Point Marie. Get your tickets now for this two-day floral festival competition. Experience our Out of This World theme gala Saturday, April 2nd. Get your tickets at theflowerfest.com.